Northrop Grumman's B-21 Raider stealth bombers teaming and operates drones. Very little information is available about the B-21 Raider, for understandable security reasons, as most of the program is black or considered highly secret. However, senior Air Force leaders have been clear that they expect the B-21 to be able to hold any target at risk, anywhere in the world, at any time. Often referring to the B-21 in the context of a family of systems, senior Air Force leaders have for quite some time discussed the new stealth bomber as expected to be capable of unmanned missions also. This concept of operations could evolve in several ways, as it could involve preparations for having the B-21 fly unmanned missions itself, or operate groups of network drones from the cockpit of the aircraft. This kind of loyal wingman capability, now progressing quickly through Air Force testing and development, enables a manned crew to control the flight path and sensor payload from the cockpit of the aircraft. This not only allows manned crews to operate at a safer standoff range but also enables operation of a forward node or sensor platform from which to conduct surveillance, test enemy air defenses or even drop weapons when directed by a human. B-21 stealth bomber, manned-unmanned teaming also introduces a wide range of new tactical possibilities, to include an ability to deliver a much larger weapons payload, increased dwell time over target areas and conduct attacks over a wider envelope or engagement area. B-21 Raider, to perform long-range conventional and nuclear missions, and to operate in tomorrow's high-end threat environment, the B-21 will be a visible and flexible component of the nuclear triad. This is the third U.S. Air Force rendering of the B-21 Raider. Through programs such as the Air Force's Valkyrie drone, the service has already demonstrated the ability of an F-35 or F-22 to fly alongside of and operate drones such as the Valkyrie. This greatly reduces latency by avoiding a need to route time-sensitive surveillance and targeting data through a ground station. 2023 is the year when the new bomber is slated to enter low-rate initial production, and final testing and preparation has been underway for months. At Edwards Air Force Base, California, we are assessing the potential to introduce a lower-cost, complementary, uncrewed aircraft into the B-21 to provide an enhanced level of capability, Undersecretary of the Air Force Gina Ortiz told reporters at the announcement of the service's 2023 budget request. The Air Force is requesting $1.7 billion to begin producing the aircraft, which will begin its first flights in late 2022 or early 2023. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.